Hi everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example about how to convert a rectangular equation to a polar equation. The rectangular equation that we're given is x times y equals 1. And remember that with rectangular equations, the equation will be in terms of x and y variables. With a polar equation, it's going to be in terms of r and theta. The two formulas that we're going to use to convert our rectangular equation to a polar equation are x equals r cosine of theta and y equals r sine of theta. And what we'll do is plug in r cosine of theta for x here and r sine of theta for y here in for y. So when we make those two substitutions, we're left with r cosine of theta times r sine of theta equals 1. And what we want to do with this is simplify it so that we get to the point where we have the equation in the form r equals and then something in terms of theta. Remember that with a rectangular equation, you usually see y equals and then something in terms of x. But with a polar equation, we're looking for r equals and then something in terms of theta. So that's what we're working toward. We're going to try to get r by itself on the left side and then have theta on the right side. So we'll go ahead and we'll multiply these two together and we'll end up with r squared times cosine of theta times sine of theta equals 1. Remember, in order to get r squared by itself, we'll divide both sides by cosine of theta times sine of theta. We'll just be left with r squared on the left side, and cosine of theta times sine of theta becomes our denominator on the right side. Now, to simplify the right side here, what we'll do is separate cosine of theta and sine of theta into separate fractions. So these two fractions are multiplied together, 1 over cosine theta and 1 over sine of theta. It's equal to 1 over cosine of theta times sine of theta. So the reason that we do that is because that gives us 1 over cosine theta is equal to secant of theta, and 1 over sine of theta is equal to cosecant of theta. So our final answer is r squared equals secant of theta times cosecant of theta. And in this case, it's simpler to leave r squared on the left-hand side than to take the square root of r and take the square root of the right side. You can optimally, if you can, you want to solve for r. If it's simpler to leave the polar equation in terms of r squared, that's fine. We often find polar equations in terms of r squared. If you end up canceling out r during your simplification process, you can also solve for theta, and that's acceptable as in terms of a polar equation, unless obviously your professor or the textbook indicates that you should do otherwise. But in this case, our final answer is r squared equals secant of theta times cosecant of theta, and this is exactly equal to our rectangular equation, x times y equals 1. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.